there were balance differences. And we try to reconcile, we try to find out the reason ki why there is a difference. And when you come to know the differences was due to this 30,000 rupees of goods which was returned by Y to X, which is received by X, but was not accounted earlier. Now it is being accounted. So the moment it is accounted, both the places, the balance comes down to 4.2 lakh. This entire exercise, whatever we did here, is called as reconciliation.
Welcome back to our lecture on Indian Contract Act. In today's topic, you'll be learning on capacity to contract. So when you were learning about essentials of a valid contract, as stated in Section 10, capacity to contract is one of the key essential element. That means the parties who enter into a contract should be capable or should be competent to enter into contract. Why? Because every party, when he enters into a contract, there are certain obligations to be performed, right? If any person does not perform an obligation, the aggrieved party can file a suit in the court and receive appropriate remedy, right? So here, whether a contract can be enforced or not depends whether the parties to the contract are competent to enter into a contract or not. If parties are not competent to enter into a contract, it cannot make a contract. It will be only a mere agreement. So let's understand who are capable to enter into contract and what are the provisions relating to these persons who are capable of entering into contracts. So let's just see the format, how a chronological resume should appear. First, your name along with your address and telephone number. Make sure every time when you write a resume, you need to write your name, your mail ID and the contact number very properly. This is the only way through which the employer in turn will contact you. Then as said, your experience, your recent experience, before that if you had anything, and next. Same way, your education, the highest degree what you possess. For example, let's say it's MBA. MBA in finance. Then your degree, that will be BCom. So then comes your skill. What are the skills you possess? If you have any special skill, all those things also can be mentioned in it.
So now, let us see a few examples to understand this concept. My problem number one is 5x minus 6 equal to 3x minus 8. So you can see in the question, it's a combination of variable and constant. But I got only one variable, or I can tell I got only one unknown, that is x. So this is an example of simple equation.
In this session, let us understand one of the key concepts of economics called demand. Now, before we understand what is demand, why should we understand demand should be the primary question. Let's take your example. You are pursuing an academic course, a professional course, because tomorrow you foresee that you will be absorbed, you will be placed in one of the key managerial positions in a company. That's why you have chosen this course. So you foresee demand for this academic course, therefore you're pursuing it.
Hi my dear students, welcome back to the next segment of this chapter. As I told you in the earlier segment that we would be discussing about different forms of business. Yes, that's exactly what we will be discussing in this segment. There are different forms of business. It could be sole proprietorship, it could be partnership, it could be a company, it could be limited liability partnership. You would have heard of all these words. Today I will be throwing light on what it exactly means. So let us begin with sole proprietorship. So to start off with, sole proprietorship. Sole means a single person and proprietorship means ownership. That means a single person having ownership.